So we were fortunate enough to attend another red carpet premiere, this time the film being Stroomop. And it was pretty fun, wasn't it, PJ?
Ach, Matthew, I had an okay time. I was upset I didn't get to meet Oukamp.
Oh yes. I think it was an unspoken thing. We were really there just to meet Armand Oukamp.
Exactly.
Nico Panaggio, the George Clooney of South Africa, he was there.
Right. We got to meet Tim Thirwan.
Yeah.
Very nice to have met you, Tim.
Yes, Tim, you cool. And your wife, you great bunch of people. Very cool to meet you. I got to declare my love for Simone Noordman in real life. Love that woman, her little fat cookness. I'm in love with her, really. Anyway, point being, we didn't get to meet Armand, so we were very disappointed.
Absolutely, just so crushed. I mean, where were you, Armand? Just between us, you were in the toilets doing a bit of blower. Red carpet event, you figured, you know, just get a bump in there.
You know,
just for the
yes.
Exactly.
Lekker. Hey, I'm Matt.
And I'm Pete.
And welcome to That Movie Review.
So known as TMR.
In Stromo, five women find themselves pitted against the natural elements of the Orange River and its surroundings when they fail to cooperate as a group during a river rafting adventure.
What ensues is a story of survival and revival as new challenges force them to confront their issues and in turn to make the necessary changes that their lives require.
Ivan Boete directs a script that he, along with his wife and lead actress Donnelly Roberts, wrote. Stroomop's timing is in line with the current move to drive more female-driven film projects.
Five women of various backgrounds converge in this film. Each one is plagued by societal and personal issues. One, for instance, works too hard and her family suffers as the result, while the other one is desperately seeking love in the wrong way.
Stroomop doesn't follow a conventional storyline. Instead, it moves back and forth in the story. While the intention is solid, the delivery is hampered somewhat by what could be called a contrived plot.
If the storyline's credibility is hampered, then it is redeemed by good acting on behalf of Donnelly Roberts, Ilse Klink, Simone Noordman, Chanel de Jager, and Carla Claassen.
These lovely actresses imbue their characters with the flaws of arrogance, desperation, emotional distance, sexual preferences, and body shaming issues. It's all brought to life under the competent direction of Ivan Boete.
There are male actors in this film. Isidingo's Kevin Smith, who played a vicious gangster in Dollars and White Pipes, shows a much softer side by playing a husband and a stay-at-home father. And then of course Matthew, Armand Oukamp, who we last saw as Jan van Riebeeck in Krotoa, now plays the river rafting guide.
Stroomop doesn't really belong to anyone in particular. Each character has a fully formed story, seen by way of flashbacks, and each actor injects their character with enough emotional baggage to bring about a tear or two.
If you're not having a cocktail, really. At the end of the day, Stroomop is about ordinary working women confronting the strain of daily living, accepting the challenges that life throws at them, and coming out, you know, overcoming the odds and for the betterment of themselves. This film is really actually about a rite of passage. Now I want to put out a little bit of a disclaimer before I give my score. Now we attended this red carpet event, right? So that means that we got to see who the actors and the filmmakers were. And you know, we were in a position to see how passionate they were about this film. You know, Ivan and Donnelly, they both got up, they both, you know, spoke.
Massive speeches.
It was really, I mean, these were long, drawn-out speeches. It was standing there, it was like, you know, when one is exposed to a situation like that, we're basically getting, you know, it's like, you know, rose-colored glasses.
They're basically handing you a pair of rose-colored glasses and say, yeah, put this on before you watch our movie.
Or beer goggles, for that matter. They say, look, put on these
beer goggles. That's why they give you so much wine before the movie.
They actually get you drunk before the film so that you can really just sit there and go, hey, cool. I'm giving Stroomop 6 out of 10. This wasn't a bad movie, but the storyline was at times contrived. And while the film is about, you know, reflection and improving yourself and so forth,
And sharing,
it doesn't really do anything much more than that.
I am a bit more of an easy lay. I do pump on the first date, etc., etc. So I'm going to give the score a little bit more. I'm going to give Stroomop 8 out of 10. Yes, 8 out of 10. PJ, are you back before you say anything? That was my initial score coming out of this film, really. And this is, those kind of glasses aside, I actually came late, so I missed all that fucking speeches. I didn't hear football. So I didn't have that effect that he had. And critically, thinking about it in a critical way, yes, it is contrived. There's nothing new in this film. But the way it was executed, I believe it was done well. The cinematography was really cool. Just that shots of the river and the night sky, you know, in the wilderness. It was beautiful. And the story itself, I won't lie, a grown-ass man, I almost, you know, let go with a little tear or two. Multiple times throughout the film. You know, a film usually has like one scene in a movie that makes you want a chunk. This movie has multiple ones, I believe. So, yeah, not really a biased opinion because I was there and, you know, whatever. I do believe this film is 8 out of 10 just for the message it was giving. The way it was shot, the absolutely phenomenal acting from everyone on screen, and a seemingly decent direction by Ivan Boeta. 8 out of 10.
So that's it this week for that movie review. Thanks for watching, guys. Please like us on Facebook, subscribe on YouTube, and follow us on Instagram and Twitter. Don't miss out, man.